A bit of a cold, had to take some medicines. Spending some time with my fans down here. Good evening and welcome to Friday night's MTV's Most Wanted, live from London, beaming out all across Europe, spreading friendship, warmth and sexy things into your living room, your hotel room, wherever you are. We're very glad you joined us tonight, and you won't regret it, because this is the penultimate Friday. Only one more Friday to go, and then we'll be history, and you'll be glad that we're not on your TV anymore. It's a very sad moment, but good evening to you at home. Thank you very much for joining us. Good evening, Big Ben Dover.
All right.
Well, how's Andy Cam?
I don't know. He's still not very well.
Isn't he? I'm just doing the bit for you, because you sort of like that, don't you?
Like that, yeah.
And good evening, Big Dean.
All right.
The security. You all right? Peace, 25G.
Your eyes and, are red, Ray.
Where's your brother? Lincoln.
Your eyes are red, Ray.
My eyes are not red. No, I'm not stressed or anything today. You think we've gone far enough with that joke?
It'll make everyone feel very sick. Sit down.
It's what youth television does, Nina. It's a very good evening to the one and only beautiful, talented, sex goddess, naughty nympho Nina. Hello, Nina.
Hello, darling.
Hello, darling. How are you?
How are you?
I don't know why I bother asking how are you, because I saw you last night, saw you this morning. Well, I haven't seen you since when you got up. It was a bit cold in bed, wasn't it, this morning?
Freezing.
It was free.
About your heating.
No, it's not my heat. That's not my heater, Nina. Anyway, are we going to have breakfast in bed tomorrow?
Yeah.
Lovely. Good evening to you at home. I've done that already. It's a very good evening to the most handsome man working in television, only for a short time only. It's idiot. I've got a perm. Phil. Hey. Good evening, Phil.
How are you doing?
Ponytail Phil.
Can I? Because you slagged it off last night when I had it down, so I just put it in the ponytail.
He's got a, but you've still got the ponytail on.
Yeah.
Look at him. Look at him, girls. Excuse me, miss. Excuse me, miss. Oh, it's Phil. Anyway, there's idiot Phil for you girls at home. And we've had quite a lot of phone calls from men as well who appreciate your stylish locks, Phil. And who else is here tonight? Oh, working the big ped cam, trying to show off Ben. You just turn around and show, look, Curtis is showing off. Curtis, do you really need a big one like that? Hey?
Bigger is better.
Curtis?
What?
Yeah. Hey, Curtis, why don't you go handheld with that one, eh?
I'm too strong. I don't show off too much.
Well, Curtis is here, so you see we've got lots of sexy boys and girls for you. And, of course, we've got lots of our friends from all the... Well, there's one person we've forgotten. Mad Martin. Hello, Mad Martin.
Hello, mate.
He gets very upset. He gets very upset when I don't mention him. Yeah. But he's a freelancer. A freeloader. You're a freeloader. So am I, actually. I'm available for weddings and parties. I am after this week. No one seems to want to employ me at all, Nina. Apart from you on the sex tour, if you're... We have all of our friends here in the studio. We have you at home. You're a very warm, caring and loving and sharing audience. We know that. And we also have people representing you here in the studio. Yes, real people from the real world. They are otherwise known as Club Bed. Now, listen, hasn't anyone ever explained to you that when you come on TV, if you hold up a big white card with writing on it, no one can see?
Why?
It has to be on coloured card. And light look like this one.
Okay, that's fine.
See? All right, greetings to the little stage in Hanover. Hello. So, you don't spell hangover like that. So we're all here for your entertainment and pleasure, to do what you want with, of course, because we're an interactive show, do what you want, take part.
Do the menu.
I'm doing the menu. There's one person we've forgotten. Wicked Will is here with us tonight, the best producer working anywhere in TV. So good that he's been hired by other people now.
Already?
Yeah, already.
But I'm still available.
No, he's not. He's not available. He's working with his new man, his new mate, and he's gone. He's left us. So anyway, yeah. Let's not get bitter and twisted, Nina. No. We'll be all right on our own. Private parts, that was my idea.
Yeah.
Phone sex, my idea.
Yeah.
Clean our souls, my idea.
Yeah.
The bingo wall of death, my idea.
Yeah, we're fine.
We're fine, we're fine. Yeah. We'll be fine without him.
We're finishing, that's what we're doing.
Yeah, no. So, let's do the menu. On tonight's show, on tonight's show we have all of the following happening. You may have heard them, you may have seen the video. It's been a big smash hit everywhere in its remixed fashion style-y. It's a great song and they're here to perform it live tonight. I'm talking about everything but the girl. Bottom monitor, Ben. It's so good. Oh, Lincoln, sir, joined us showing off. Good evening, Lincoln.
I'm going home. Hello, mate.
There's no light over there, Lincoln.
Good. If I was smiling up in my eyes a bit, you might see me.
You said it, I didn't. Have you lost a tooth or something?
No.
Oh. All right, you look lovely and handsome.
Thanks. I've just come from VH1.
Oh, yeah, VH1.
Yeah.
Was it fun and exciting?
That means something.
Was it fun and exciting, Lincoln?
It was live. It was an hour.
Who was your presenter on VH1?
Richard Adamson. He's nice. He's very nice.
Very nice man. Okay, Lincoln, nice to have you with us. Thank you very much, Lincoln.
Lincoln.
And Everything But The Girl are here in the studio playing live. They're on the monitor and Fluffy Internet Phil, the most gorgeous blonde guy working in TV. He's over there, I know, but Curtis is hopeless at following everyone with his camera. Fluffy Internet Phil's with us tonight, and he has gone to a lot of trouble to get our web connection, and it's here, Everything But The Girl. We have a web page, so look, Fluffy Internet Phil's here every night, selling drugs, going to the club bed girls and asking them out, and doing this. And look, it's a...
Pat's partner in crime.
It's a web page, okay? Pat's partner in crime. So thank you very much, Phil, and that's it, really. But at the moment, let me tell you about tonight's fabulous Friday competition. It's truly fabulous, although it's a little bit more disappointing than I hoped it would be. but it is pretty intensely fabulous. And anyway, don't let me bore you with it. Here's the gorgeous man who prefers men to women, but then it's the 90s, so we're all happy with that. It is, of course, Wicked Willie.
Thanks, Grandad. This week's amazing competition could see you winning some exclusively signed instruments from those infamous grandads of rock, the Rolling Stones. You could be the proud owner of guitars, cymbals and a harmonica straight from the lips of Mr. Lips himself, Mick Jagger. You see, you really do win with MTV's Most Wanted.
What is that?
It's a funny bone in my water, Nina. No, keep it. It's a funny bone. Keep it, because it might have some jokes for us. The hell's that doing in my water? Are you poisoning my water?
No, of course not.
Of course you wouldn't. But there we go. That's a rather interesting package, idiot Phil told me. Very good. Those are the prizes you could be winning tonight. But now, look at the menu. We'll be taking a look at your private parts, of course. But now...
Yes, the celeb!
Oh, but now! No, Curtis. If you've been watching the auction all week here on MTV's Most Wanted, we've stretched it as far as we can possibly go. But then... Yes, Curtis, thank you very much. So when you get to my age, you need to stretch it as far as it can possibly go. Believe me. But we've stretched it quite a long way. And we've come up with a lot of money for a charity. Not we haven't come up with the money. You at home have. Because you are the most loyal and loving audience we've ever known. Well, you're the only audience I've ever known, really. But, no, but you are. And it's the best gig we've ever played. And thanks. Good night. I wish I was a pop star. Anyway, talking about the auction, we've been auctioning they're not there, are they? Paintings all week long. We wanted to give our money to an Eastern European AIDS charity who are working with children who, through no fault of their own, are HIV positive. And we're glad to say that we've raised a lot of money. And here is the final list of the people. Bear with me if it's not you, but a lot of people have taken part in this and we want to give great big thanks back to them. Before we go any further, actually, we want to give a lot of thanks to you who pledged money. And we also want to give a special message to those people who phoned up last night and the night before and made Nina work very hard phoning you back to check if the money was, straight and that you did actually want to spend money. And some people phoned, Nina phoned them up and they said, no, we were drunk. And we thought it was funny, and we've got a special message for you people if you wasted our time, and here it is. Well, that was quite an adult way of dealing with things, wasn't it? But you people are sick and we don't want you to watch the show anymore, and you know who you are, so get off and go and watch something else that doesn't need love and care to make, okay? Because we've got a lot of lovely people watching this show. And sorry to start the show on such a bummer, but something terrible has happened, really terrible, and it's a strange old world when things like this happen. We phoned up a man a couple of nights ago, Bert, his name is, in Norway, and Bert Anderson is his surname. He was a lovely man. We phoned him up and he pledged, was it just... Thank you, Nina. £1,600 for the fantastic drawing of The Most Wanted Crew, wasn't it? By Suzanne Vidman. We've got a fax from Suzanne as well, actually, but we'll talk about that later. Well, Bert pledged it, and we phoned him up and said, are you sure you want to spend £1,600, Bert? You know, just for a few squiggles. It's a lovely drawing, but it's only us, and it's not like it was the painting by Jean-Paul Gaultier. And he said, I don't really care which one it is, Ray, because I just think I want to give my money to a good cause. And he was a lovely, lovely man, and he just wanted to give us £1,600, and... you would think that in all the powers that run the world, that he would be a safe guy. Well, unfortunately not. Nina phoned him up today to make sure the money was there, and the money's there, but he's not. Apparently, yesterday, he was involved in a terrible car accident, Bert, in Norway, and he's now in a coma. And what can we say? It's very, very sad, and we hope that he's okay. Nina's spoken to his friends and family, and all of our feelings are with Bert, but it's a funny old world, isn't it? He gives us something, and then someone else takes it away. We're sure he'll be all right, though, because we're all thinking about him, and we will, of course, be keeping the painting for him, and who knows, we might even give it to him for free and get MTV to give us the money or something like that. But it's pretty horrible. Yeah. Bert in a coma, and I know it's a bit of a bummer, but these things happen, and it's terrible. So, anyway, getting back to the people who are still here and who have all of the paintings, the Robbie Williams painting, the last ever European TV appearance of Robbie Williams, goes to Frank... Robbie Williams. Yes, okay. Robbie Williams, the painting goes to Frank in Germany. Frank, thanks very much. £5,500 that painting is now worth to you. Simon Le Bon, the painting of the lips goes to Guy Hoffman in Belgium, I think. Guy Hoffman, thank you very much, Guy. And you don't say how much it is, Nina.
It's
going to
take you forever. I've gave little.
Oh, it's all down on the TV.
I've given it to you.
What a brilliant idea. Well, I'll just sit here and pick my nose then. I'll show you, Jean-Paul Gaultier goes to Robert for £2,500. Suzanne Vidman goes to Bert, we know that. Wet goes to Evie in Germany. Dave Stewart goes to Mattin in Germany. Matt Johnson goes to Oliver in Germany. Dreadzone goes to Jeff in Germany. A lot of rich people in Germany. But we know that already. Dreadzone goes to Jeff in Germany. Animation goes to the animation cell, goes to Elizabeth in Denmark. The Bingo Wall of Death. Are we doing it? No, I don't know if we are.
We'll decide at the end
of the show tonight. Dinner with Pat goes to Sonia in Birmingham, and Nina's Wonder Bra goes to Stefan. You'll be glad about that, Stefan. You voted for it about 20 times. The last tickets for the last ever show, next Friday evening, December the 15th. Tune in and see The Cure play live, only exclusively here on MTV's Most Wanted, and tune in and see a grown man cry all night long. And Nina will be crying. Yeah. We'll all be crying next Friday. That goes to Collie in Germany. Thank you very much, Collie, for spending about £2,000 on that. The dodgy script goes to Darren from Ireland, Petra from Germany, Eric from Germany, Sigrid from Germany, Susan in Germany. Are we actually watched anywhere else? Pat's teddy bear goes to Craig from Germany. A signed T-shirt goes to Dennis from Holland and Victor Canilla from Gibraltar. Thank you for all of your money. And just basically goodwill, people who don't want anything. Natalie, Mark in the UK, Sue and Lisa in Moscow, I remember you two, Nicole Elmer in Germany, Andy Smith in England, doing a lot of hard work for Most Wanted Friends, Andrea Volk, a very special viewer, James Savage, a very special viewer too, and Neil Kirby. And listen, thank you for all of your money. We couldn't have done it without you. Someone is going to be very, very happy somewhere in Europe, because your money is going to go to a place that needs the money more than anywhere else. Do you want to know how much we've raised so far? I'll tell you. Here it is, on your MTV screen now! £19,409! All that money, £19,409, will go to a charity. We've chosen the charity. They don't know that they've got the money yet. We're going to try and call them up right now. Nina, could I have the paper, please, darling?
paper.
The paper of the charity with the details on it. Thank you, Nina. Let's hope they're in, because otherwise we're going to have to try and find another way of spending £19,409.
I know.
I know too, Will. Yes, I think we all know. Yep. So let's have a look at this. Nina, yep. Would you just sort of walk across the shot to fill in a bit of dull space? I'll just do this.
You've read it.
Just do it, Nina, would you? Go on. Well, I'm doing this. Don't go. Just walk across. Why don't you do want to do it? You're a beautiful woman. Can't be bothered.
Hello.
Hello?
Hello, my name is Susanna Jelanek.
Hello, Susanna Jelanek.
Hi.
You are live across Europe to 159 million people.
Oh.
On MTV's Most Wanted, but...
Oh.
But don't let it worry you.
Because the problem, I can't see the TV because it is coded in Hungary.
I know. I spent some time in Hungary and I know that half of the country is now coded, Susanna.
It's this.
But listen, tell me who you are and why I'm phoning you up. Are you the head of an AIDS foundation in Hungary?
I'm a paediatrician and infectologist, and I'm dealing with HIV-infected children in the last 6 years. And I have a foundation for... the name of this foundation, the Hungarian Paediatric AIDS Foundation.
The Hungarian Paediatric AIDS Foundation.
Exactly.
Okay. Now, what's your actual work, the work that you actually do?
Usually our patient came from Romania, so... Maybe you know there is a very big problem in Romania.
Yep.
There is more than 3,000 children who are infected by HIV.
And you're sorry, Susanna, you're taking a lot of them from Romania into your foundation in Hungary, aren't you?
It's not too much NGO in Hungary. We are the only one who deals with HIV-infected children.
Okay. So you're basically looking after children who are HIV positive, and you're trying to give them a good life while they're still here.
Exactly.
And you're also, of course, funding all of the medical things you need to do.
Yes.
It's a Hungarian Paediatric AIDS Foundation. And basically, I guess you must need some money, Susanna.
Oh.
Do you need any money? Or have you
I would be very glad to have some money. So we have lots of goal and lots of very good purpose to have some money.
Good. Because I know that the money... what do you need money for?
To fight against the isolation, which is one of the biggest problems of the child.
Mm.
And we have a very nice boy who have more than 5 years standing at the hospital because even his parents refused to care about him.
This is a little boy who's been at your hospital for the last 5 years because his parents have abandoned him because he's HIV positive.
Yes, it's true.
See, when we live over here in London and most of Western Europe, we are sort of getting used to the idea now that, you know, everyone who is HIV positive and who has AIDS is not, you know, a disgusting, terrible person, and they need to be looked after. But you're still fighting a lot of prejudice over there, aren't you?
Yes, we would like to do that.
Okay, good. So, you have a lot of children you work with. You've got
not too much. About 30 children who are visited our hospital, but nowadays we have 7 families and this boy... whom I spoke about.
Yes, the little boy. What's his name, the little boy?
Daniel.
Oh, yeah, we hope he has a lovely life. Now, so if we were to give you some money, it would help you do even better work, would it?
Oh, I would be very glad.
Well, I think we're about to do that, Susanna, actually. Because for the past few days here on MTV, we've asked our viewers, and they're the best viewers that anyone could wish for anywhere, we've asked them to give us some money for an AIDS charity in Eastern Europe. And do you know how much we've got, Susanna?
No, I don't know.
We've got... we have £19,409, almost £20,000. That is a lot of money, isn't it?
Oh, it's terribly lot.
Would that make a big difference to your foundation?
Of course. It's impossible. It's fantastic.
Well, Susanna, I think I can speak for everyone who watches this programme. We can't think of anyone who deserves it more. All of the people here in the studio, we all agree. All of the people who've pledged their money, I'm sure they agree. Susanna?
Oh, yes.
We're going to give you £20,000!
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I'm very moved and I'm very pleased, and thank you.
Susanna, listen, if we can do it, don't thank me, thank the viewers of Most Wanted, and if we can do our bit for people like you, who make this world a much better place, then we can all feel happier when we go to bed tonight. And thank you, Susanna.
Thank you.
And I hope the money goes down well, and have a very happy Christmas, and give little Daniel all of our love.
Thank you, and I wish the same for everybody.
Okay. Susanna?
Yeah?
You're a very special person, and keep doing the great work.
Thank you.
Bye-bye,
thank
darling.
You.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
I could have bought myself a sports car with that money. You know. Susanna and people like her, we all need more people like her, and thank you very much for everyone who sent in all of the money. I know I'm coming across like one of those horribly sincere TV presenters now, but I am. You know I am. And thank you so much for every little bit, from the £10 we got for a T-shirt to the £5,500 we got for a painting. Your money is now going to a great project over in Hungary, to all of our friends there. Thank you for that. Everything But the Girl is after the break. Make sure you join us then. And what about the Cure Boys, Don't Cry, Nina? It's nothing to do with this at all.
Oh.
Could be coming later. Thank you, Nina. You've just ruined my perfect ending. Oh, well, that's life. Join us after the break for Everything But the Girl. And if you're watching in Hungary, great stuff. And we're very happy that the money has gone to a great cause. And thank you for your time. See you in a minute. It's Most Wanted. The show that makes a difference with your help. Yes, we can all wear little red ribbons, but with your help, we can raise lots of money for someone who needs it. Wasn't that a really sad story about little Daniel? His parents have abandoned him. I mean, some people are unbelievable in this world, but hopefully your money is going to make it all better over there to our friends in Hungary. As you know, I went to Budapest recently, and they treated me like a VIP, and they're lovely, lovely people, and so we've given something back with your help. We've got some facts. I'm not sure if I can show this one, Ben, because it's got naked people on it. You can't see that, can you?
No,
I can't.
It's
one of my favourite women. It's Helena Christensen, naked with Michael Hutchins.
Show it!
You got me in trouble now. Who said show it? It's all very well being from Germany and saying show it, but here in England, don't you know that they don't like having rude things? Oh, dear, the English. Suzanne Vidman, the girl who did the painting, sadly, for Bert. In a coma. God, here she is again. Look, Nina.
Yeah.
£2,000. Incredible. She thinks it's fantastic. Susanna, you deserve every penny of that because you're a brilliant artist.
Yeah.
And thank you very much for that, Suzanne. We've got some more pledges coming in for scripts, actually. So if you still want to pledge any money, you know where the money's going now. Don't, you know, just keep it coming. And I was going to do that, Nina. I was going to do two. Nina, little naughty nympho Nina, she gets lots of faxes, but this man, Rune Brokstad in Norway, he faxes all the time, and he just called to say, I love Nina Ferguson. She's mine. All right. Runa, you're not a top TV presenter, and I am.
Yeah.
And so Nina is with me.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And we've had sex before marriage.
Yeah.
Haven't we? Yeah. So, Runa, sorry about that, mate. There's Edwina DeMay, another lovely regular viewer. Thank you. We're going to miss you terribly next week, but let's not start all that sad bit now. Will Andy Cam make it to the Most Wanted next week, Friday? Probably he will, won't he?
He will.
And will Rob the cameraman be on the last Most Wanted?
We're not letting him in.
Yes, he will, Ben. Yes, he will. He'll be here doing Ben's job. And we've got this special request. I think, Club Bed, would you mind doing a happy birthday all together if I just say who it's for? Are they alive? Yes, they are. Okay, would you please wish my girlfriend, Lucy Lachinska, a very happy birthday? And will you please wish Jessie, Nina and Jessie, would you please wish Jessie a happy birthday? She's the best little sister in the whole wide world, and she means a lot to me. And Andrea Voke, where's that one? Will you, tonight is Jessie Bonciepi's 14th birthday, and from Jessie. So basically, Club Bed, would you do us a quick happy birthday to all those people?
Happy birthday to you. To you. Happy birthday, dear
home. Everybody.
Happy birthday to you.
Hey! Thank you, Club Bed. Curtis, that was the most boring camera work I've ever seen. Why don't you zoom in and move around? This is MTV, not VH1. God's sake. Okay, well, after that near musical...
Oh,
after that... After that near musical moment from Club Bed, let's go to some real music here on MTV's Most Wanted. I can be a nice guy and I can be a horrible guy too, you know.
Yeah. We know.
No, I can't. No more Mr. Nice Guy for me, Nina. It's all straps and whips tonight for you at home, I'll tell you. Let's meet the band. And yes, there they are. Everything but the girl are Tracy Thorne and Ben Watts. They met at university way back in 1982, and it wasn't long before their romantic liaison turned into an artistic union. They named the band Everything But the Girl after a second-hand furniture store in Northern England. Since 1984, they've released 6 studio albums, but things were put on hold for a while as Ben recovered from a lengthy near-fatal illness. They also took time out to release the album Amplified Heart, and you're about to hear the single that's storming Europe. Here they are, Everything But the Girl. Good evening. Good evening, Tracy. Good evening, Ben. Good to see you again. And good evening to the man on the percussion. Martin. We're very happy and lucky to have this song live here in the studio because, as you know, it's been a massive hit absolutely everywhere. And as soon as I heard it, I knew it would be. Yes, I can't talk. I can notice those top pop hits when I hear one. So turn it up, and whatever you're doing on a Friday night, you're going to enjoy this moment brilliantly. This is Everything But the Girl and the single Missing.
I step off the train, I'm walking down your street again, past your door, but you don't live there anymore. It's years since you've been there, and now you've disappeared somewhere, like out of space. You found some better place, and I miss you. And I miss you, oh. Could you be dead? You always were 2 steps ahead of everyone. We walked behind while you would run. I look up at your eyes. I can almost hear you shout down to me where I always used to be. And I miss you like the deserts miss the rain. And I miss you, yeah, like the deserts miss the rain. Off the train, I'm walking down your street again. I'm past your door. I guess you don't live there anymore. It's years since you've been there, and now you disappeared somewhere like out of space. Found some better place, and I miss you. Yeah, and I miss you. Yeah, like the deserts miss the rain.
MTV's Most Wanted, Martin Cams on Club Bird. What the hell was that, Martin? What was that throwing it up in the air business? You're showing off.
Yeah.
It looked very good, though. No, no, it looked good.
Very sensitive.
He's very sensitive. It looked good. And Curtis, I bet you couldn't do that. Martin, no. Because you're on that big boring camera.
Boring cam.
Boring cam, yeah. So, very good evening to you. Yes, thank you, Curtis. Don't you girls laugh. You've got no idea what he's talking about. Have you? Oh, maybe you have. Here's a special message to, seeing as the cameramen seem to be as important to this show as me. Everything But the Girl, did you enjoy that? We thoroughly enjoyed that. That's a fantastic song, and we never thought we'd get them in to do that. It's wonderful. They'll be back later on. Yes, Ben Cam. According to Mona Brockstad in Norway, Big Bend Over Cam is horrible. To say he's not going to let sweet Rob the cameraman back in. It's been a long and cold winter without Rob.
I'm only joking.
He's coming back next Friday. He'll be here on the show. Tune in and see The Cure playing live, exclusively their only TV appearance this year. And tune in and see us all in tears, probably. It'd be horrible. I'm not looking forward to it at all. No. Then you just blubbered spit all over him. Disgusting. Anyway, tonight, though, tonight you could actually win something to do with the Rolling Stones. Instruments signed by the Rolling Stones. Should we roll the VT or the numbers or what? I'm sorry, I'm on the wrong page at the wrong time. But anyway, you could be winning guitars and harmonicas and cymbals signed by the band themselves, exclusively for you at home. All you have to do is pick up the phone and get through to us on our competition line, and you could be taking those instruments home with you. So, here's the numbers to phone. Thank you, Will.
Good evening. To enter our fabulous Friday competition, just dial your international code, then.
4-4-1-7-1-7.
5.
7.
7.
0. 0. 1.
Once again.
4.
4.
1.
7.
1.
7. 5.
7.
7.
0. 0. 1.
I'll just do the factors on my own, shall I, Nina?
I did some.
Those are the numbers to phone for tonight's Friday night. Just joking, darling.
Okay.
I'd never be horrible to you. You're a lovely girl. I'll leave those factors over there. I've got another one to show you later on after 9 o'clock because it's giving me inspiration. Looking, Ben.
Sorry.
It's not late enough yet to be officially naughty here in England. It's all very well you being European. We're trying to be European too, but we're not allowed to do anything naughty until 9 o'clock at night time. And then the government said it's okay, so we have to keep everything inside till 9 o'clock.
Very frustrating.
Oh, very frustrating, Nina.
Yeah.
But we have a bloody good time after nine, let me tell you. We're keeping it in all day long. There's a girl over there who looks completely bored. Are we keeping you awake?
Yeah.
No? The girl in the Scottish hat.
That's me?
Yes. Didn't sound very Scottish to me. Right, okay. When in doubt, get it out and have a look. And have a look at your private. Ben, will you stop being so inventive? Parts. Gah! 15 minutes left. Right, okay, your private part says where we ask you to send in something that you hate about your girlfriend, boyfriend, not your mum and dad, although you tend to do that these days, your brother or your sister, something that they own, that you can't stand, they love, they refuse to get rid of, send it to us, we'll post it to Pat and destroy it violently. Let's get on the... I've got it right after 6 months!
Hello?
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 Is this Lucy Hurd in the UK?
Yeah.
Hello, Lucy. Hello, Lucy! This is Ray Cokes, MTV's Most Wanted, live from London.
Yeah. You joke.
You... are you okay, Lucy?
Yes.
Well, you sound in a very good mood, Lucy.
Yes, I'm fine.
You are in a good mood, aren't you?
I was.
Because I'm not sure how much longer your good mood's going to last, Lucy. because you sound like a lovely lady, but there is someone very close to you who you've upset by owning something pretty horrible. Your husband, Dave, do you know him?
Yes, yes.
Well, he sent in something to Most Wanted that he doesn't like, and he's asked me to destroy it in front of your very eyes.
Yeah.
You're a bit shocked, aren't you, Lucy?
Very, yeah.
But it's only me, look. It's not a clever TV presenter.
Don't stare at too much.
Oh, sorry, Will. It's only me, Lucy.
Just having a drink.
Are you? You can't have a drink, it's not 9 o'clock yet.
Sorry.
Now, Lucy, you can have as many drinks as you like.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have any idea what your husband Dave has sent in to us?
Not really, no.
You've not noticed something missing from the house?
A few things.
Few things? Well, we only have one, Lucy.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I have two, but Andy Cam has one. But we only have one of your private parts with us tonight.
Well, I think I've both of them here at the moment.
You've got two private parts? Well, that's handy. Lucy, don't think about it, Ben.
Sorry.
And Curtis, don't think about it. Don't think about a lady with two private parts. We don't want any thoughts like that on this show. Mm-hmm. Now, Lucy, Curtis, don't think about it. It's not 9 o'clock yet. We're not allowed to. Lucy, one of your private parts is in this box here, and it's pretty horrible. And it is pretty horrible. We're unanimously voted it pretty horrible.
Yeah. Right.
Lucy, to put you out of your distress, and don't blame me, blame Dave. It's... Ready, Ben? Ready? Lucy, it's this.
Oh no.
No. Lucy, it's a teapot. Lucy, it's your teapot.
It was.
It still is. It still is. Now, where's the letter from...
Down there.
Lucy, just while you get your breath back, I'll... Hey.
Nice ass.
Ah! Oh, sorry, Lucy. But Wicked Will just said nice something to me in my ear. Right. Lucy, this is what your husband Dave has to say about this teapot.
Right.
Do you have a collection of teapots, Lucy?
Just a small one.
You're only supposed to have one because they're only to make tea in, you know.
Oh, no, they're just for ornamental purposes.
Ornamental purposes, okay. Well, your husband Dave says he actually bought this for you.
Yes, he did.
But he says you're a lovely wife, and he's got some photos here, Lucy, if I can find them. Let's have a look at Lucy. Yeah, it's the lady we're talking to right now. It's not that funny. Are you? You're on holiday there, aren't you?
Yes.
Butlins?
Yes. Not quite. Florida.
Florida. Lovely. So you didn't go in any for topless sunbathing then, Lucy?
Not that year, no.
Not that year. Okay. You didn't go in for any topless sunbathing, Lucy, but you did go in for some bottomless sunbathing. So, Lucy.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I wasn't supposed to show that one because your husband Dave said you might be very upset.
Yes.
Are you upset?
No.
Good.
Why did you send it in then?
Lucy?
Yes.
Your husband Dave says, a couple of years ago I bought this, but I've always, always hated it. She insists that it has pride of place in her teapot collection. You see, you do have a big collection. In the kitchen. She'll probably kill me when she realises what I have done with the pot, but it's had enough. And one way or another, it's got to go, says Dave. Is he with you tonight, or has he gone down the pub?
No, he's here.
He's there. Mm. So you can get your revenge, Lucy.
I will later.
Lucy, we could put a fitting end to this little teapot of yours. And let me just whisper a little secret in your ear. Wicked Will won't like me for doing this, but Lucy, Dave says that if you're really upset and you want another one, he'll buy you another one anyway.
Cottage, right?
Okay. And no one else heard that, did they? No, fine.
No.
What did you just say, right?
Nothing, Will. Nothing. I was just talking to Lucy about sunbathing.
All right.
Ooh,
oh, dear.
I've got it. There it is.
You're going to break it.
Lucy, if you let us... What are you doing?
I'm holding it.
You're holding it? Okay, you hold it.
That's not...
If you let us post this to Patch, Lucy,
yeah.
We in exchange will give yours and Dave's sex life a massive boost because we'll give you this most wanted bed set so that the next time you do it, you can make love on us. Where's the duvet cover?
I couldn't get my camera in the bed.
Oh, you couldn't? Oh, there's a duvet cover. Lucy, here's the duvet cover.
You have to sleep with me, camera.
Look, we've already got one pathetic man on this show, it's enough.
Oh, all right, sorry.
Oh, dear.
Lucy.
Yes.
This most wanted duvet, as modelled by the hunky Curtis. People keep writing in and asking if he's going to be in films next. Not me. Curtis.
Wait for Debbie to ring me.
Debbie does Dallas, doesn't do films anymore.
Oh,
God's sake. Bed set, duvet cover, and I've got a strategically placed Most Wanted logo. Strategically placed for those married moments. And a couple of pillowcases. What do you say, Lucy? It's a difficult choice, isn't it? This or this?
Oh, it is a difficult choice, Ray. Would you send me two T-shirts as well?
Two T-shirts as well?
Please.
Yeah.
One for each of your private parts.
Well done, Curtis. So can we post it to Pat, Lucy?
Yes. Go
yeah! Say goodbye to Ben. Go ahead, noisy lot tonight. Come with me, Lucy. Let's go and see what pathetic Pat has in store for your teapot. Now, this is King Henry VIII, isn't it?
It was, yes.
It was. It's particularly nice, Lucy, but let's see what... Oh, my God, Martin. That looks a bit serious, Pat. He's quite scary, actually. Pat, here's Lucy's teapot. What are you doing?
Playing hangman.
Playing hangman?
Yeah.
Oh, what, because it's Henry VIII?
Yeah.
Off with his head?
Off with his head.
Oh, very good, like, because he cut all his head's wife's heads off, didn't he?
Off of them.
So, Lucy, yeah. Pat's got a really poetic end for your Henry VIII. He's lovely, Pat.
Be gentle with him.
Be gentle with him, he says. Did you? By the way, you haven't had your slap? Oh, no, Dan, you've got that big axe in your hand.
Yeah.
Have you got an axe to grind? Lucy, some parting words to your lovely teapot?
Goodbye, teapot.
Is that all you can think of saying after all these years? Goodbye, teapot.
Good riddance, teapot.
Good riddance, teapot. Okay, Pat, she's ready. So, now you look quite... That's dangerous, Dad. Now, what should I do, Pat? Just lie it down, or like that?
Shall I take its head off first?
Take it, chop its head off first, Pat.
All right, then.
Lucy, here we go. Be careful, Pat.
Ready? Off with his head.
Oh, Pat, you ruined the whole thing!
Oh!
Look, you chopped off his body off as well as his head.
Oh, yeah.
Better finish it off, Pat.
Okay, then.
Look out, Martin. Oh, Lucy, it's gone into a million pieces.
It's gone.
You can't put tea in there anymore, can you? Well done, Pat. That's very good. You've been... Oh, dear. Lucy, he's gone to a lot of effort because now, Pat, what's this over here?
Oh, I was going to use it, but it was a bit dangerous.
A bit dangerous?
A bit dangerous.
Well, it's like a guillotine in France, isn't it?
It's very sharp.
It's not, Pat. It's a
very
prop.
Sharp.
It's a prop.
No, it's sharp.
You could have done this on Lucy's thing. It would have been better than that.
No, it's not.
Here's a cucumber I found lying around.
Oh.
Lucy, calm down here. It's not 9 o'clock yet. Pat,
yes.
Prove to me that this is not a prop.
Okay?
I'll hold it, shall I?
Yeah. Okay,
and
then.
See, because... Go over there like this. Now be careful, Pat. It's just a prop. I'm not sure it won't cut this cucumber.
You ready?
Yeah.
Oh,
it's quite sharp.
It's very sharp, Pat. It's a good job you didn't use that. God, it's a good job you didn't use that. Let me
have. I know. I cut my finger on it earlier as well.
You did. You're lucky you didn't use it. It's really dangerous, you silly man. Now where's that cucumber gone? Because I need to make a salad. Can you get me a cucumber for me?
I can't quite get it. It's over there.
Hey?
It's
somewhere around there, Pat.
Where's it gone?
It's just down there, Pat. Have a look. There it is, Pat. I can see it. You get it? Right. There it is, Pat. I'll go do it myself.
That's wicked.
Pat, are you all right?
Feeling a bit lightheaded.
You didn't tell me it was a real guillotine, did you, you fool?
It looked like a real guillotine, didn't it?
God, I'm so sorry. What are you going to do now?
I'm going to try and find the rest of my body.
Try and find the rest of your body? Oh, God. We've really overdone it, haven't we? Pat, yes, your body's over there, mate. Go and find it over there. Pat, over there, look. There it is, Pat. He'll be all right, Lucy. Don't worry about it. And Lucy?
Yeah?
Thanks for your teapot. And thanks for being with us, OK?
That's all right. Thanks
lovely to
a
see
lot.
You there. Bye-bye, Lucy.
Bye.
And just to annoy you, here's some ads you really hate. Bye, Pat. Go down to pub, Pat.
Wanna live with common people like you? Wanna live with...
Where's Pat's head gone? Nina, have you seen Pat's head?
Yeah, I've got 3 goals of it.
Did you? I bought it in the studio to show everyone and it's not here.
I think it went over next door's fence.
Did it?
We'll have to ask him for it back.
No, I'm not asking.
He's kicking it around.
Curtis, you're kicking it. Good. Excellent. Look. Fluffy Internet Phil's been busy again with the Everything But The Girl webpage. Thanks, Fluffy Internet Phil. We love him. Okay. Oh, dear. Thank you very much for all of your... You're continuing to pledge money since we've given £19,400 and something pounds to an aid charity working with children in Hungary. You keep pledging. Gregory from Moscow says, I'll give another something. £100, is it, Nina? Gregory from Moscow, thank you very much. Because all the money's an aid charity. I want to give £50, says Dejan Slibar in Slovenia. Hello, Dejan. We love you. And lots of people are still pledging, so thank you very much for that. Keep the money coming in. We'll tot it up at the end of the night and tell you how much we have got. And seeing as it's now 9 o'clock, let's show you what Helena Christensen and Michael Hutchins look like, Nina. Why not? Wouldn't mind of being there myself, actually. Okay, let's go. Let's have a quick look at the girls in club bed in the front row, Martin Cam, because look at what are you doing, you girls. Yeah, lads, see this? What does it mean? What, these photos are supposed to explain everything, are they?
No, the lads, they're always trying to see us, so we're getting better than them.
Oh, they're trying to see your boys.
They went to Israel and we're all around Europe now. That's the lady got as far as Israel. So we're greater. And happy birthday, Pugsy.
So what are you four girls doing with these four boys then? Are they boyfriends?
No, they're just our mates.
Just your mates?
One of them is.
And they're always trying to see your boys, are they? Is that what you're saying? Disgusting. And the man on the end's got a sign as well, hasn't he?
There you go.
What, Bonehead from
Happy
Oasis?
Birthday,
Bonehead. No, not him, nah. Oh, another geezer.
Another Bonehead. Well, nah, very nice to have you with us, Bonehead.
Nice one.
We'll just explain to our European cousins the word geezer. Can you please explain the word geezer to our European cousins?
Geezer. Bloke, man, male, you know what I mean?
Great bloke.
Yeah, male,
gentleman.
Male species, geezer, man.
Right, okay, so there you go. When you come over to London next summer, go around and say, oi, geezer, to everyone, and they'll love it. Okay, well, thank you, girls. Those are the sort of girls we love in the studio. But time for me to stop waffling on about nothing at all and bring you tonight's Fabulous Friday competition, which is the last one ever in the whole history of MTV's Most Wanted. It's the last one ever we'll ever do, because next Friday we won't be doing one. But tonight is quite fabulous. You could win yourself a whole collection of instruments. Thank you, Nina. Signed by the Rolling Stones. Now, these are quite good guitars, Martin and Co. They're really good guitars. This one's signed by... Who's that? Someone from the Rolling Stones. They are authentic. We asked the record company to get them to sign them for you. They are all authentic. There's guitars. Thanks, Phil. There's a harmonica signed by Mick Jagger. There's a cymbal signed by Charlie Watts. And another guitar signed by Ron Wood, probably. Okay. And brilliant. So you could win all of this stuff and start up your own band. Thanks to MTV's Most Wanted Tonight thing. Thank you very much. Okay. All you need to do is using your skill and judgment, Nina. They are authenticated, they are signed by the Rolling Stones. Only we can get you this close to the stars on MTV. So let's help you win by introducing you a member of Club Bed. I'll ask you 3 questions about the member, and if you answer correctly, you'll win all of those instruments signed by the Stones. So, cue lights and music! Knackered Neil, there you go. And good evening to Katrina Stormer from Germany.
Hi, Ray.
Hello, Katrina. Katrina, how are you?
Fine.
Good, and thank you very much for agreeing to do this.
It's all right.
Nothing too embarrassing, apart from the last question, which might be a bit embarrassing for you, but we'll try and make it as gentle as we can.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Katrina. So let's take some calls. Big bend over. Here. Line 3 is John in Lisbon. God, we don't go to Portugal very often. Hello, John.
Hello.
John.
Yes?
Good evening.
Good evening.
Are you in Portugal?
Yes.
Lisbon, a beautiful city. Thank you very much for phoning in tonight. Are you a big fan of the Rolling Stones?
Yes, I am.
Okay. Do you have any guitars?
No.
Well, you could be owning 2 guitars this evening. Let's put them over here, Nina. Very good idea. You could be owning all these guitars and the harmonicas and everything.
Don't play them, Ray.
I won't play them. Hang on a minute. Simply sexy. No chance to play them over.
Don't encourage him.
And for my encore. No. John, enough of that crap. Let's help you win, John. You can see your MTV, can you?
Yes.
Okay, have a look at the lovely Katrina. Say hello to Katrina.
Hello, Katrina.
Hi, John.
It's actually it's Katrina Stormer, not Stormer.
It's Stormer.
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 Stormer. Tris. Right, John, three questions to you. And A, B, or C. Just give me your A or the B or the C. I'll ask you three questions. If you get all of them right, you'll win all the instruments. Is that clear, John?
Yes.
Good. Okay, not very clear to me. Okay, what is Katrina's hobby? You know what hobby means?
Yes.
Okay, fine, you have to be sure. What is Katrina's hobby? Is it A, collecting roof tiles, the things on top of houses? Is it B, playing the piano? Or is it C, watching old editions of Most Wanted on tape?
C.
C, watching old editions of Most Wanted. Okay, John, what is...
B.
B, playing the piano?
Yes.
Okay, well, you want to change? Okay, fine. What is Katrina addicted to? Is it chocolate cake? Is it fried seaweed? Or is it ice cream?
Think A.
You think A, chocolate cake? Okay. John, what is Katrina's most embarrassing moment? Is it A, when she caught her parents making love in their living room? Is it B, when pathetic Pat asked her to go for a date in the pub tonight? Or is it C, when she lost her shorts in the middle of a volleyball tournament in front of the whole school?
I think it's C.
You think it's C, when she lost her shorts?
Yeah.
Okay, John, I can tell you, John, that you have two wrong. Sorry, John. Next caller, please, Ben.
Line 5.
Line 5 is Mehmet in Turkey. We are going all over Europe tonight. That's good. Mehmet.
Hi.
Hi, Mehmet.
Hi.
How are you?
Nervous.
Don't be nervous. It's only me and MTV.
Yeah, and 150 million people.
150 million people? No, that was before we scrambled. So now it's only 10 people in Europe. So don't worry, Mehmet. Good luck to you.
Thanks.
Are you a big fan of the Rolling Stones?
Yes, and I'm a guitar player.
You're a guitar player?
Yes.
Hey, what do you think of my guitar playing?
The great Martin.
Stop it!
It's good. Okay. These are good guitars, aren't they?
Of course.
They are. Martin are very good guitars. Okay, well, very good luck to you, Mehmet. We hope you win.
I do.
Take your time. Three questions. Same questions to you. And if you don't understand, just ask me again. What is Katrina's hobby? What does she like doing with her spare time? Collecting roof tiles from the top of houses? Playing the piano? Or watching old editions of Most Wanted on tape?
B.
B, playing the piano. Quiet club, bed, you naughty girls. Very good. Very good. Take your time. You're doing well. What is Katrina addicted to? What can't she get enough of? Chocolate cake, fried seaweed, or ice cream?
What was the second one?
Not important.
Which one do you think?
I'm not telling you. Which one do you think? Does she look like a girl who eats lots of chocolate cake, lots of fried seaweed, or lots of ice cream?
C.
C?
D. Ice cream.
Ice cream, okay.
Not good.
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 Now, last question to you.
Yes.
Now, Mitch, for the big star prize tonight, if you get this right and you've got the others right, you could be winning.
Oh.
God, you are nervous, aren't you? Just take your time, Emmett, because you're doing very well. What is Katrina's most embarrassing moment? Is it A, when she caught her parents making love in the living room of their house? Was it B, when pathetic Pat asked her to go down the pub for a date tonight? Or was it C, when she lost her shorts in the middle of a volleyball tournament in front of the whole school?
A.
Be quiet, club, Eddie, you naughty people. You just said A.
Yeah.
When she caught her parents making love in the living room of the house.
Out of time, Ray.
We're out of time. Well, Mehmet, I'm not sure if you're going to be happy about this, but out of time, unfortunately. So we can't take any more callers. So let's just ask Katerina and see if you were right anyway. We're out of time. Sorry, Mehmet, but we are out of time. That's a television rule. If we're out of time, we can't take any more calls. And you will have to be the last call. And I don't think you did too well. But let's ask Katerina. Katerina, could you please tell Mehmet in Turkey what's your hobby?
It's playing the piano.
Playing piano?
Yeah.
Mehmet!
Yes!
You've got one right so far.
Okay.
Now, Katerina, what are you addicted to? What can't you get enough of? What do you eat all of the time?
Ice cream!
And you said ice cream, Mehmet!
Yes!
So, your most embarrassing moment, Katerina, I bet it was when you were playing volleyball and your shorts fell down.
No.
No?
No.
I bet it was when pathetic Pat asked you to a pub.
No.
No?
No.
What was your most embarrassing moment then, Katerina?
It was in fact when I got into the living room and there were my parents.
And your parents were making love?
Yes!
Mehmet, you're absolutely correct! Hey! Yes! Excellent. Let's bring up the lights, shall we? I think there's time to bring up the lights. Mehmet, how do you feel? You've won yourself two guitars, a cymbal.
Put it down.
Can I tell you something?
Hey?
Can I tell you something?
Yes, Mehmet, whatever you like.
Yeah, for 4 years, I've been watching you nearly every night, and at the end of every day, you make my day better. Thank you.
Oh, well, thank you, Mehmet. Thank you very much. And at the end of every day, I come here after a hard day, a sad day, a long day, a boring day, and you make my life better too by being out there. So
and can I have an autograph of you and Nina?
Of course you can. Now, before you go, you're going to need to know how to play this guitar. So, Mehmet?
Preston, A minor. A minor.
A minor? Well, that's all we've got time for. Mehmet, don't thank me. Thank the lovely Katerina.
Thanks, Katerina.
Hey. Thanks a lot for watching, Mehmet. Bye-bye. Oh, great. So Mehmet in Turkey has won. We've never had a Turkey competition winner before, have we?
Nope.
Fantastic. I don't think we have. And we'll never have one again. Katerina, thank you very much for sharing those intimate secrets with us. If you wouldn't mind, I know your parents are watching. Were they naked at the time?
I'm sure they're not.
Sorry, okay, fine, good. Well, thank you very much for sharing that with us. Let's give her a big, warm round of applause, Katerina Stumme from Germany. Mehmet, you're going to go to bed a very happy man tonight, and I'm going to go to bed with a very happy man tonight myself. Ooh, no, I'm not. I'm waiting for Will. Okay, so next week there will be no Fabulous Friday competition because it's the last ever Most Wanted ever in the history of Most Wanted. So no competition, but we will be bringing you this band live. It's The Cure. Cue the man in the horrible jacket. That's me. Why do, when you become a TV presenter, do you always have to wear horrible jackets like this, Nina? It's disgusting. Thank you very much for your time this evening. And Mehmet in Turkey, enjoy your newfound guitars and cymbals and everything. And we've got to do a big thank you to Bernadette Herson from Budapest, because with your help, we've sent £20,000, the money's still coming in, to the charity working with children who are HIV positive in Hungary. And as you know, half of Hungary, three quarters of Hungary can't see MTV anymore because they've scrambled the signal. Not my fault, not ever something I agreed with, you know that.
Just buy them all the decoder.
Yeah, well, can't buy them all the decoder because we're running out of time. But listen, Bernadette Herson from Budapest, Bernadette was the actual girl who saw the show last night and phoned up the charity because they were scrambled and they didn't see us and suggested that they phone us. So thank you very much, Bernadette, for putting that together. We much appreciate it. And we also appreciate people like Rafael in Warsaw in Poland who just bothered to send in the fax that says that. That's lovely. So, shut up, will you, cynical old fool. Bit more, sir. Please tell Curtis that he's really sexy. ND from Vienna. No, I will never say that to Curtis. Thank you very much for... What? This is the last Friday night show. We'll be back again next week for the very last week of Most Wanted ever in the history of Most Wanted. Next week we have Rebecca Tornquist on Tuesday. She's from France, so she should be popular with you. St. Etienne on Wednesday, that's good. Skunk and Nancy on Thursday. And for the last ever show, we're very pleased that Robert Smith has personally agreed to come along with The Cure next Friday for your pleasure and entertainment. And just in case you were worried about Pathetic Pat, he's here. Was he here? Is he gone? Pat, come on over quickly. We haven't got much time. He's here, and he's all right, and he's in one piece. Look.
Well, it's a bit sore.
You'll be all right. You'll be all right. Special effects and everything.
Very good.
Yeah. You'll be all right down the pub.
Keeps coming.
Yeah. See, he's all right. And Pat, you keep that guillotine there because we're going to ask Mr. Chirac to do a visit next week to the studio. Don't tell him what it's for or anything. Right, okay. Okay, right, let's go. That's time for us to go. Thank you very, very much for your time and all of your money this week. Been absolutely wonderful to give us all that stuff. Thank you, Club Bed. You've been absolutely horrible. And that's it. This is the album, Amplified Heart, Everything But the Girl, on which you can find Missing, although not perhaps in the same version that you're used to it. But that's available as a single. You heard that earlier on. They're going to play as an exclusive new song now from an as-yet-untitled album. I believe it's the new album next year, is it? It's the new album, out early next year, so this is the exclusive song for you at home. Thank you very much for your time. Have a lovely weekend, and I'll leave you with Everything But the Girl, and don't forget to join us for our very last week, starting next Tuesday at 9 CET. Ta-da, take care. This is Big Deal, Everything But the Girl. Bye.
What is things that you want to feel. I don't think you want to feel.